This video is made for anyone who's working hard to become a UX designer. It's not going to be easy, and that's exactly why I'm making this video. Hey everyone, I'm Aliana and welcome back to my channel. I learned UX design through taking the Google UX Design Certificate courses, and I landed my first part-time design contractor role 3 months after that, and a full-time UX design role 4 months after the part-time role. I made so many mistakes in the process, and I'm making this video so that you don't make the same mistake. When it comes to entering the field of UX, what I see is that there are two groups of people. For the first group of people, maybe you have a design degree, or maybe you have some design background in visual design, or maybe you came from a design bootcamp, in which the bootcamp provides you some opportunities to work with real-life clients. If you are this group of people, you already have real-life projects to showcase in your portfolio, and you can move to the next section. Now for the other group of people, which definitely includes me, you're probably learning UX design on your own, trying to make a career transition while still working on the full-time role, and probably taking online courses by yourself. I don't suggest you to jump directly to look for a full-time role, because that's going to be very difficult in this extremely competitive field, and you might be really disappointed by the rejection letters. What I suggest you to do is to first look for an opportunity to work in a real-life project. This can be a short-term internship, a freelance project, or a part-time design project. For me, I did a part-time design project for a startup, and that really helped me to get a sense of what it's really like to work within a team, what it's like to have actual design constraints, and how to work around these constraints. There are two application materials that we can leverage: resume and portfolio. Now remember that recruiters are not UX designers. Let's talk about resume first. I learned this in the hard way. And if you have job experience, you probably already know this. First, make sure to build your resume either in Microsoft Word or Google Doc. Don't use a design tool. Make sure it's one column, not two columns. The resume that's made by fancy design tools will not pass a resume scanning app. I learned it the hard way. Okay. Make sure you're throwing as many keywords as possible related to UX design. Make sure each bullet point involves a number. It can be the number of months you work on this project, or just try to estimate whatever you did. Increased stakeholder satisfaction rate by 10% or something like that. And if you work on a design system that speeds up the process, say increased delivery efficiency by 5%. And for each bullet point that you put down, make sure to start it with a different action verb. You can find it from this action verb box. Now for the portfolio. I suggest you to build your portfolio through Squarespace, Behance, or Notion. The benefit of Squarespace is that it gives you a domain name, so yourname.com. The benefit of the other two platforms is that they are free, and it's way easier to edit. And when it comes to portfolio, make sure that the real-life project is presented on the top. And my biggest tip is actually to improve the visual presentation of the portfolio. Use a great banner. Don't make it like too fancy and doesn't even highlight the content anymore. Highlight the content, but present it in a way as if it's iPhone ad or something like that. And here's a resource to check out good portfolios. So I'm not going to show you a one-size-fits-all template, but here are some key things that you can include in your portfolio that will be very helpful. For me, I found it helpful to state the problem at first and then directly show my solution and then go through the process. Most of the explanation when it comes to this project will be explained through your work during the actual interview instead of during the resume or portfolio scanning process. People won't read much, but they will definitely see what you did. And check out this video if you need more tips to get started. When it comes to the case study, just make sure the first one is really, really good. The second and third one, you probably won't present in your interview at all, and you just need to make sure they are there and follow the similar template. Doesn't have to be perfect. Now let's talk about actual application. Make sure the first thing you need to do is to understand your strength. This is not something that everyone talks about, but understanding your strength, it's so important. I did it the way where I would do it, which is just sending out applications without connecting to people on LinkedIn. but you can definitely play the LinkedIn game if your strength lies into digital networking. LinkedIn didn't work out to me. Focusing on quality instead of quantity didn't work out to me. Applying to large companies directly through their website didn't work out to me. What really worked out to me is applying on Indeed. What I did was that I applied to 15 roles every day for the entire month. And I only spent 30 minutes on my application per day. So, 2 minutes per application. And that's actually helpful. And here's the secret. When you apply to a company on Indeed, you're not just applying to one company. You're also sending your information to a recruiter. And usually, the recruiter has more than one design opportunities. So whenever a recruiter calls back to you, he or she can link you up with more resources or more opportunities that fit you better. And sometimes the recruiter is working in a staffing agency. And in that case, your information can be sent into their agency and their agency will help you to find a full-time role. And that is what actually worked out to me. I got linked up to around 2 agencies and they have a lot of contractor roles ready and all the contractor roles are well paid full-time. And that's how I got my full-time role through the agency. My first suggestion when it comes to interview is to accept every single interview. Because it's always better to learn more about the company and it's always better to practice. Before you go into the interview, you can try to talk through your portfolio, but don't make it too stiff. Because I definitely over-practiced my portfolio before some of my interview and I felt like I was being not so natural. I think it's so much better to be natural. Another thing is that research their company thoroughly. If you understand their product so well, then they'll be impressed by how much homework you've done, and that will give you a much better chance. Another thing that works so well for me is that I make sure to ask everyone in the room to introduce themselves first. Well, first of all, this makes people feel like you care about them, they have some words to say, and second of all, you understand the background and the context a little bit more. Not everyone in the room are designers. Some people might ask questions from, let's say, a marketing point of view or an advertising point of view. And knowing a little bit about them can help you to prepare a little bit while you are, you know, having the interview. Final advice when it comes to design interview is to ask a lot of questions. Especially ask questions about them. What was it like when you first entered the company? And is it different from today's work? If I get this position, who would I be collaborating with? What product or project management framework does your team use? Do you use Agile? Do you prefer email communication or do you use Slack? How do you handle design constraints? Especially, how do you handle constraints from the engineering side? And how to work with the engineers and the PMs? These questions will give you a lot of insights about the company, allow people to have time to talk, and definitely help you to kill a little bit of time. That's pretty much it for the advice. Yeah, I got some final thing to say in the end. Again, it's not going to be easy to enter the field of UX design, simply because right now, the supply is much higher than the demand. I sincerely wish the world has more UX designer because I understand the value of UX design and I'm sure you do as well. I went through a period of time where I was losing hope of me becoming a UX designer or getting a role at all, no matter part-time or contract. And for me, the worst time in this entire process is when I feel like I am a full-time job seeker because that's not the work I want to do. I hate sending applications. I was only spending 30 minutes per day focusing on application. And other than that 30 minutes, I was learning something else. And you probably think from my channel, I finished 2 other certificate courses. I was working part-time in another role and I'm working on my own YouTube channel trying to share what I learned in design. Make sure you don't stop design while trying to apply for a design role. I'm a firm believer that if you can improve a little bit in design every single day, then there's no way that you cannot find a design role. So I really hope that this video helps you. And for anyone who wants to become a UX designer, I believe you can do it. And let me know if you need anything else. Honestly, right now, it looks like the world is collapsing, but I hope that you don't collapse. See you next time.